गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स. सो टुडे वी सी अनदर एग्जांपल ऑफ मैट्रिक्स स्पेस. सो दिस इज लेट एक्स डी बी एनी मैट्रिक्स स्पेस. दैट इज वी हैव गिवन एक्स इज अ मैट्रिक्स स्पेस. दैट इज डी दिस फंक्शन डी इज गिवन टू बी मैट्रिक ऑन एक्स. देन शो दैट द फंक्शन डी वन डिफाइंड बाय. So this another function d1 which is defined in terms of this metric d. We have to prove is a metric on x. We have to prove this new function d1 is a metric on x. So here as this d is given to be metric on x means for the element of x this function d satisfies all the four properties of metric. And for this new function d1 to prove this d1 is a metric on x, so we have to prove all the four properties in the definition of metric for the this function d1. So we prove here all the four properties one by one. So first property, so as d is a metric, so that's why d satisfies all the four properties of metric. D satisfies its first property. So since d of xy is greater than equal to 0 for all xy belong to x, so as this is greater than equal to 0, so definitely this d of xy, this is greater than equal to 0, and this denominator is a 1 plus d of xy. This is greater than equal to 0 and plus 1. So denominator is greater than equal to 0, numerator is greater than equal to 0, so that's why this ratio is greater than equal to 0. And by the definition of this function, this ratio is nothing but d1 of xy. As this is greater than or equal to 0, therefore d1 of xy is greater than or equal to 0. So first condition is satisfied. Similarly, by the definition of metric function, by the second property of metric, that is d of xy is equal to 0 if x is equal to y. This is given. So this is 0 if x is equal to y. So definitely, so numerator is equal to 0 if x is equal to y, and denominator, so means finally this is 0 if x is equal to y. By the definition of this function, this ratio is nothing but d1 of xy. So d1 of xy is equal to 0 if x is equal to y. So second condition is also satisfied. So similarly, again we use here definition of metric D. This is given to be metric. That's why by the third property of definition of metric, D of xy is equal to D of y comma x. So this condition is said to be symmetry for all xy belong to x. So D of xy upon 1 plus D of xy is equal to d of yx upon, this is true because here these are equal, so in place of d of xy I write here this value d of yx. Again similarly in place of d of xy I write d of y, so both are equal, and this is nothing but d1 of xy, right hand side is nothing but d1 of yx. So here three conditions of definition of metric are proved here. So lastly we have to prove the triangle inequality. So now here we prove here this triangle inequality. So that is for the triangle inequality, we have to prove the triangle inequality for the metric d1. That is we have to prove here d1 of xy is less than equal to d1 of xz plus d1 of zy. We have to prove this. But here in this given example already we have given d is a metric, so that's why in the definition of metric by the last property, by the triangle inequality for metric D, we have D of xy is less than equal to D of xz plus D of zy. This triangle inequality is such that, so in between x and y this another element z is a lies in between x and y. So this triangle inequality is a distance between xy is less than equal to distance between xz plus distance between z y. So this is given. So if we add 1 on both sides, so this inequality remains same. So now here after this step, so by taking reciprocal on both sides, so what happened if we take here reciprocal? So this quantity is greater, and after the reciprocal, so it has a reverse inequality. That is likely. Suppose here this relation 5 is less than 7, that is 7 is greater, and if you take here reciprocal of both sides, so then what happened? 1 by 5 is greater than 1 by 7. So likely, so this one is greater, and by taking reciprocal, we have this inequality. So now, so here we subtract here both the sides from 1. Manje apan ithe kay karnar ahet, 1 madun hi left hand side pan subtract kartoy ani 1 madun right hand side pan subtract kartoy. Mag ata ithe kay milel aplyala? 1 madun apan subtract kartoy manje ji quantity mothi ahe ti 1 madun subtract kelyanantar ti aplyala ti side less milel. So here I have an example that 0.75 is greater than suppose 0.50. This suppose the value of this left hand side is 0.75 and value of right hand side is suppose 0.50. So what happens? I am subtracting from 1 minus 0.75 and right hand side is 1 minus 0.50. So its value is 0.25 and this is 0.50. So now which one is greater? This one greater. So we have now right hand side is a greater one. So now by the cross multiplication, we cross multiply this total quantity into 1 here as it is minus 1 into 1 minus 1 divided by denominator as it is, just by the cross multiplication. This is less than equal to, again here by the cross multiply, this total quantity into 1 as it is minus 1 whole divided by same denominator. So what happened? This plus 1 and minus 1 gets cancelled, and we have this left hand side d of xy upon this as it is. Similarly here, this 1 and 1 plus 1 and minus 1 gets cancelled. So we have this remaining numerator upon same denominator. So now just here on the right hand side, this denominator is common to these two terms, sum of the two terms. So we just write this denominator separately, that is d of xz divided by this denominator plus d of zy upon this denominator. Just we have written this denominator separately. So now we here this left hand side is less than equal to this term plus this term. So now just here we see now this quantity that is here d of xz. So first term of the right hand side d of xz divided by 1 plus d of xz plus d of zy. So I want to compare these two terms, here this term and this term, d of xz upon 1 plus d of xz. So what is the relation between these two quantities? D of xz upon these two terms. So now here denominator is a greater, this term is a positive, d of xz, because distance between any two terms is greater than or equal to 0 by the definition of metric. This is positive, this is greater than or equal to 0, again this is greater than or equal to 0. So this denominator and this denominator, so the difference between two denominators is this denominator is greater, this denominator is greater and this denominator is less. So here in these two quantities, the denominator on left hand side is greater, that's why the value of left hand side is, so this is less than equal to. So likely for this second term, सेकेंड टर्म इज ए डी ऑफ जेड वाय डिवाइडेड बाय वन प्लस डी ऑफ एक्स जेड प्लस डी ऑफ जेड वाय एंड लाइकली दिस इज लेस देन इक्वल टू डी ऑफ जेड वाय अपॉन वन प्लस डी ऑफ जेड वाय. सो नाउ इन प्लेस ऑफ दिस क्वांटिटी ग्रेटर क्वांटिटी इज दिस एंड इन प्लेस ऑफ दिस क्वांटिटी इज अ ग्रेटर. सो आई जस्ट राइट ग्रेटर क्वांटिटीज दैन दिस टू टर्म्स. सो नाउ हियर राइट एंड दिस इज लेस देन इक्वल टू डी ऑफ एक्स जेड अपॉन वन प्लस डी ऑफ एक्स जेड प्लस डी ऑफ जेड वाय डिवाइडेड बाय वन प्लस डी ऑफ जेड वाय. सो हियर नाउ वी हैव our left hand side d of xy upon 1 plus d of xy means by the definition of this d1 function this nothing but left hand side is nothing but d1 of x comma y is less than equal to. So this term d of xz upon 1 plus d of xz this is nothing but d1 of xz and plus similarly this is nothing but d1 of zy. So we have proved the triangle inequality for the metric d1. So for this function d1 we have proved all the four properties in the definition of metric. That's why this d1 is a metric on x. Therefore d1 is a metric on x. And so as this d1 is a metric on x means this new metric space x d1 is a metric space. So we have proved here this example.